Hello, and welcome to St Wilfrith's Abbey. There's an additional mod released today for Gothic style architecture. So I will have to make some changes to my abbey now that we have new blocks available. But first I thought, before I make any changes, I'd just show you a quick video of what I've managed to do with medieval engineers in about 120 hours of play. We're going through the west door into the nave of the church. Font. Gallery. Minstrels Gallery. Something similar to Exeter Cathedral, which is more finely decorated than this one. The pinnacles were constructed using several different pieces. Gauze tracery for the windows, very nice, and glass in the windows provided by another mod. The north transept to the south transept. The pulpit. No seating except a couple of benches for the oldest and most infirm members of the congregation. And then we come into the choir where the stalls are. Not as nicely decorated as I would like, but we can only do what we can do. The presbytery. 12 chairs for the monks, the red leather one for the abbot. The altar. And east window, the light coming in. And stained glass provided by yet another member of the community. Excellent work, guys. Have a look in the crypt. Someone's left a candle behind. Need more tombs in here, I think. That one's floating. Floating, I'll have to fix that later. If I could make the bell tower work, this is where I would attach it. Stairwell up to the gallery, the view from the south transept. Door leading out to the library. More comfortable chair for the librarian, benches for the other brothers. Out of the library and let's take a look at the dormitory. Quite pleased with this. This is the monk's dormitory. A couple of desks. For writing. Not much space for personal possessions, because they probably didn't have many. I've kind of placed this somewhere in the late 13th, early 14th century in England. And then underneath the dormitory are the cellars. Stockpile of various goods. From the cellar up into the kitchen. It's a nice day, so let's open the shutters. And from the kitchen, of course, to the refectory. Again, the abbot's chair in the middle of the high table. Plenty of light on the south window, south wall. And a pulpit for lessons. While the monks eat. From the refectory, let us go into the cloisters, can be accessed through the south, from the south transept. That cat is barking mad, so I'm sure some of you know what I mean. No doubt that will get fixed in time. Nice tiled area for the cloisters. Sometimes monks were in the habit of using the north part of the cloister where there was plenty of light to do some writing. So let's put a desk there just show that. The scriptorium might have been a room, but very often it was just a place where assigned for writing. copying. This is the lay brothers' dormitory. A little bit more cramped, less comfortable looking. Might change the central supporting beams. They look a bit too narrow, don't they? Might push them a bit further out to the edge. And from the lay brothers' dormitory, the toilets. And the warming room, the one place in the abbey where the monks can warm themselves, especially in winter. And here we are, the cloisters, again some of that lovely tracery provided by Wolfgar. I would like to put a sort of formal lawn area here. But at the moment it's very difficult to get a piece of level grass. Or level grassed area. I might have steps down into this area from the cloister or up from the cloister. I've seen both types of arrangements. There are steps up into the forgot what this is called from the garth. There are steps up into the garth at Wells. Is it Wells Cathedral? And steps down. I'm trying to think where it is now. Is it Norwich? Norwich Cathedral? I'm not sure now. But, look around. Anyway, both options are available to me. From the library, Yes, let's go to the chapter house. No, vestry first. Here we are in the vestry. Where the monk who's saying mass can prepare for entering the presbytery. We should probably have some steps at the back of the altar. Later. So the vestry, the sacristy, into the chapter house, where the business of the monk's chapter is all carried out. Here, 11 chairs around, plus the secretary's chair. And additional chairs around the outside for lay brothers, members of the chapter. And from the chapter house, let's have a look to see where the abbot resides. This is, I suppose we would call it a solar. I could possibly make an extra room in here. Nicely tiled floors. Up to the abbot's private bedroom. He gets a double bed. Big comfortable double bed. A small guest room and a larger guest room for a more important guest visitor. From there you can see the covered passage leading to the infirmary. two doors. This one's not covered. Again, a desk for the hospitaller or herbalist, whichever they have, whoever acts as doctor here. Up the stairs, more beds. And the infirmary has, of course, its own kitchen. And its own little chapel. More benches, because these are for mostly sick people. But very simply furnished. And finally, from the infirmary, we go to the great barn or tithe barn. Small slit windows. I can't avoid using the arrow slit windows. I would like to use something different, but it's not available. Just ordinary slits, as I've seen in great barns at Bradford-on-Avon, for example, or in Wiltshire and Hertfordshire, I think it is. Bit empty at the moment. Would like to have more basic things to put in here, like stacks of grain, big stacks of grain. I recently visited a barn, a working barn on a farm, and the whole area was full of grain. The grain attracts mice and rats. So we have a little guardian to protect them, chase off the scavengers. A little bench as well to sit down, take a rest while storing things. Now, this is my attempt at doing some sort of buttressing, but thanks to the new update, the new mod that's available today, I'm going to be able to change all of that. Quite looking forward to it. Not too happy with the coins. The coin stones are... they extrude far too much from the walls, I think. It would be better if they were half that width. But they certainly look okay at a distance. They look good at a distance. They look very good. I'm pleased with it all. And then there are a few village houses trying to work on using the voxels for modding the soil and the grass. I'll get that right later. First of all, welcome to the Reeves house. He's got some items. Furniture, not a lot. Something to cook. Might have even had a fireplace, but he has a separate room for a bedroom because he's the most important man in the among the rustics in the village. This one, I'm not sure who this house belongs to. It's a timber framed probably not someone quite as wealthy as the Reeve. He's got a longhouse, traditional English longhouse, but this guy has a dog. It's a very scary looking dog, isn't it? Another rustic's house. This one not so rich. I need something that's going to operate better as a bed. Not happy with that, obviously. But I don't think they had particularly comfortable beds like we see. The only bed that's available in the game. I think something a bit more basic would be appropriate, with maybe a straw palliasse on top of some maybe a rope strung frame. I don't know. This wicker fencing is to put some animals behind for the winter. Maybe that's where you keep your cow in the winter. The hen house, very nicely done. Some really lively looking chickens. And then a very simple peasant shack hovel. Again, not happy with the bed. Something's got to do change about this. Yeah, okay. Oh, shut up. Okay. I started working on some strips for strip farming. These are 220 yards long and 20 yards wide. Not easy to get a grassed area between the strips. The area between the two strips is called the sick, and I need to work on the voxels to fill that with grass. The wooden fencing is only there for my benefit, to show me where these strips are. I need to put in quite a few more yet. Finally, the windmill. Need to get a working rotor. But once we have that again in the game, things will look a lot better. Windmill is on several levels. Oh, I'll fix that later, that hole. We should probably have a cat as well up here. Certainly all the flour and grain would attract a lot of vermin. Cute little rats. Personally, I don't mind them at all, but did I put some of those in the cellar already? Oh yeah, okay. And this is where the cornstone is. I can't quite make this work properly. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, but I will learn in due course. Find it somewhere. So there we are. There's the Abbey of St Wilfrith. And now major refurbishment required for all those lovely new Gothic blocks that we have to play with. And I think I might put a water mill in down by the I might replace the windmill with a watermill down in the valley somewhere. But great fun, wonderful to play, excellent value for money for medieval engineers, I think, if you like that kind of thing, building construction type games. I love it. But 120 hours of fun on this. Combined with a little bit of frustration now and again. What I would like to be able to do is maybe I could persuade or pay someone to produce a few grotesques these little carved stones I've put up temporarily in place of all those medieval grotesques you see in the from the Middle Ages on the cathedrals and churches, well, large churches, abbeys. I don't know how I would do that. I'm not a modder. I'm not sure I have the patience to learn how to do it either, but I see there are a few guides I might get around to it. But what would be ideal is if you could have a range of, say, 20 different faces of genuine grotesques that you could just stick on these bosses, perhaps. Or something similar. Anyway, I'm sure there's a good mod producer out there who could make that happen. So, St Wilfrith's Abbey. Thanks for watching. And now,
user joined your channel.
Hello.